Because deployment of System 001 was a first of a kind, we needed to make sure that we were prepared for it and we were ready to deal with the unknown. So 2 years ago, we actually started a work together with an independent company that helped us understanding the risk and the consequence of deploying System 001 into the ocean environment.
We're here at NOAA Southwest Fisheries Science Center conducting a training today with people from the ocean cleanup so that when they're out in the field, whether it's deploying their boom for trash collection or whether it's recovering the trash from that's accumulated in that boom, they'll have better knowledge of how to care for animals that they might interact with. And ultimately, if the ocean cleanup team is able to complete their job, the oceans are going to be a better place at the end of the day.
The safety of the animal and the safety of the people have to go together towards the main goal, which is having a successful mission. When we basically step on the boat and we started to sail out towing Wilson behind, we already started observation, we already started monitoring the environment. We want to make sure that the barrier was safe for the environment from the moment it will leave the coast till the moment it will return on it. We had an independent observer from Seiche Group, and they are marine mammal and protected species observer. They joined the vessel.
I'm here as a protected species observer. And what a protected species observer does is they continuously monitor the marine environment for marine animals, in particularly marine mammals and turtles, so whales and dolphins and turtles. And so what we'd be continuously doing while we're up on the top deck scanning the oceans with our binoculars is looking for signs of life. So that could be anything from splashes to blows, and maybe also we're looking for signs of bird activities. Then we would note down what animals we have there and also maybe their behavior and if they are displaying any behavioral traits towards the barrier itself.
Technology like this to try to solve a problem has never been developed before, has never been deployed before, and the only way to learn the possible consequence, a possible effect, is basically to be like a doctor on a patient. You have to monitor constantly, try to understand what are the changing, if there is any, and try to mitigate them. We had to make sure that we were able to really understand what was going on in the environment surrounding the system. To do so, we basically used technology, like for example, drone and an autonaut. An autonaut is a complex machine that uses wave motion for propulsion. The autonaut that the ocean cleanup used in this mission was, for example, equipped with wave motion, with ADCP that allows you to understand the current, or underwater camera, for example. And basically, it's an instrument that allows you to do visual inspection in the middle of the ocean, also when the weather conditions don't allow human operation. It can be in a heavy storm and still be moving around. We used this extensively during mission number one because the autonaut can really move near the system up to less than 2 meters from the barrier, collecting videos of above and underwater and sending all of this in live streaming to the boat.
In addition to the visuals that we're doing, we're also monitoring acoustically for marine mammals. So Seiche have provided the ocean cleanup with passive acoustic monitoring drift buoys. We deploy these drift buoys. They float free of the vessel, so they're not attached to the barrier or the vessel. And it's really cool technology that we have is because they will send the signal that is received by the hydrophone straight to the vessel in real time. So I can monitor for any acoustic signals that are in the area, so whether that be from a marine mammal or just boat noise, I can monitor that in real time from the base station.
As a result of 4 months of monitoring of the system in the ocean environment, we can say that the system resulted really safe for the ocean ecosystem. We never saw a real accumulation of neostone or plankton or eggs, for example, in any part of the system. We never had any interaction either with fish or with protected species or with any other component of the ocean environment that resulted to be damaging the ocean environment. what we will do, what we will continue to do at the ocean cleanup is think about the environment at the same time that we're trying to solve the problem to develop the right technology to rid the ocean of plastic.